Alright everybody, here it is. It's the Sonim XP 5 Plus from AT&T. I'm a little bit late to the game because I saw a few videos of someone else that had these. I've had mine for a while. I just haven't had a chance to get around to doing a video or anything on it. It's basically an upgraded version to the XP5 Plus or XP5S I've showed before how to put Zello and everything on. I've showcased it before in that regard. But coming from the XP5 Plus, you got some additional buttons rather. This one here is going to give you access to your notifications rather than the previous model where you had to hold down one of the buttons, get a menu, go into your notifications that way. This one just gives you a dedicated notifications button. You still have your quick keys, your left, right, up, down, that you can get into whatever you set it for, be that messages. You can even set something for your OK button, be that messages, camera, Zello, browser, whatever you want to set those for. This is just a setting shortcut, apps, and like I mentioned already, the new quick launch your notifications. You got your standard button. This everything else is pretty much the same as previous, on off, end and call. It's USB-C. You got your standard proprietary jack for all your Sonim devices all the way up to the new XP10. You got your volume up and down here, push the talk button, and I'll show you on the back, it's got your screw and your charging contacts and all that. You have a button here. This one, I didn't have any other use for it right now other than it just opens the web browser. Volume, which is actually a hard, goes in steps. It's not a radial, I think that's what people call them, the one that just turns. This one goes in steps, but it doesn't have like a stopping point. You can just go all the way around, but it does go in increments, kind of like a channel knob. Think of it that way, but this is the volume knob. This is the channel knob. The channel knob does, in fact, work. Let me show you before I get ahead of myself. The channel knob, in fact, does work in Zello, in the free Zello with that. Maybe I can get this off. There it is. That's all that is. Just a plastic case. It's actually pretty thin outside that. This, where it's kind of rounded off here, and it kind of gets flatter up in here. In the literature that I've saw from the XP10, it kind of takes the same body shape of this. Your lanyard hole there. Another thing about this case I want to point out before I forget, it is nothing special. It's really just a piece of plastic, and this part has some, what is that stuff, felt or something, just to keep anything from getting scratched or anything. Got your cutouts here. The Valor mic will work while the phone is in the case, and it'll also work while the phone is in its belt holster. I believe it's from the same manufacturer. I have a case like this for my XP8. That mic works flawlessly with the XP8, of course, but it will not work in that case because it has bigger bezels. It just won't seat properly. Nor will it the way these little arms line up on the XP8 case. See how this one gives it just enough room to be in there? the one for the XP8 doesn't. It would be like, you know, it wouldn't be all the way down in there. Without getting off on too much of a tangent, if you buy these for a business, you got a nice place to, of course you'd want to put one on your phone too, because it's going to be removable. Not accountability tags, but what is it, asset accountability or asset tracker, asset management stickers or barcodes. Be a nice place to put those on and keeping track of who's what's what. But of course, on the back here, you got your camera and your flash, branded AT&T. Pretty soon, or maybe not pretty soon, but soon, sooner or later, I'm pretty sure that these will come out like everything else did on Sonim's website as an unlocked model. This ran me, I did add it to my AT&T bill, but I did not get it on installments. You can, but new, everything with warranty, taxes included, set up ready to go, costed me right around $315. The device itself is around two something, I think. If you have AT&T, go ahead and check it out. It's still on their website, as well as the XP10, which runs about $550. Don't quote me on any of these prices. They more than likely will change. But both of them I have seen, you can get them like just about everything else. You can get them on your installment plan. Now, this is set up right now, running Zello in the background. This will work a channel, and it will speak the channel out. So if we just go ahead and give a
04 radio check.
So you want the 04 radio check. That's just what I named the Echo feature in Zello. So all you gotta do, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. But if you get closer. 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have to set it up. You can only go so far with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Then you can go ahead and into your Zello contact, your individual contacts, or your settings. I believe there's two ways of doing it. It's and set up your volume. To rename a channel, all you have to do is come down here to this little down button. You want to go ahead and click it, and you can go down to it's not easy to do through that viewfinder, rename channel, and it'll give you the option to rename it. Now you're going to have to put a two-digit number in there, and just got the standard screensaver. You want to put a two-digit number before your contact name or channel name. So, like if you, like I just did, that's my fourth channel. So it's 04. And then the name of the channel, instead of just putting Echo, I just put Radio Check. You want to make sure you always have a two-digit number in there. And if you want to reorganize your channels, you want to make channel 1, channel 5, or channel 5, channel 4, or channel 10, channel 1. Just, you don't have to do anything other than go in, rename channel and switch your number around. So if you have some guy in your contact list that you're in a ham group or whatever with, or whatever be the case, was a ham radio, and it was North Tower. You would go 01 ham radio, North Tower, or whatever abbreviation or anything you wanted to use, like that. Or say you have a contact that you want to be channel 2, you would put 02, and then that, you don't have to put contact, but you just put that, that person's name. And then if you want to, maybe put something in there like, you know, direct or one-to-one or solo, or, you know, however you want to distinguish channels from contacts, because it doesn't tell you unless it's only going to read or speak aloud what you rename the channel as. But that's about it for this. I'm liking it so far. I've had it for a couple months. Really do like it. You know, it's not a smartphone. It's not for everybody. But this is just a secondary phone to me. Primarily, it's push to talk. I very rarely answer a phone call or get a text, or unless it's like a, you know, advertisement from AT&T or something. I very rarely ever get a text on it. I don't even think I've given anyone this phone number. It's mainly just a secondary thing for me, and I would rather have this any day over any of the other Chinese things that's coming out. And that's a totally fine way to go if that's what you want. You want an Enrico, you want whatever. It seems like hundreds of you know, names out there. You got the same thing, but with, you know, different manufacturers, you know, different people out there just putting their name on it. But this right here, 3-year, I think. Maybe I might be wrong, it might be 2-year, but I think it's a 3-year warranty. I've called them before because I had a problem with this, which brings me to, not a problem, this was just kind of weird to me. If you get one of these, when you go to fill out your warranty information on your, or on the Sonim website, or you call and have them do it by phone, take the battery out, look at your IMEI number directly printed on the sticker under the battery. Because I don't know if this is just mine or if other ones are like this, but the IMEI number that you find inside through the settings and about phone is missing a number. The IMEI number that you find in the device by going into settings and looking at it is missing a number on mine. You have to actually take the battery out, take the screwdriver, take the battery out, physically read the number that's printed on the phone. I've never experienced that before. I knew there was something wrong whenever their form is telling me I had an invalid number. And I know very well that this was a new phone. AT&T just sent it to me, and it took me a couple days to figure it out. I didn't even think about looking. I've done it so many times with other phones, switching IMEI numbers, or rather giving my IMEI number to AT&T, having them switch it on so the hotspot or features and everything will carry over. I've did it so many times through the settings, and never once occurred to me to physically look at it. But make sure you read your IMEI number that's printed directly under the battery on the sticker, because I don't know if, like I said, I don't know if it's just mine, just a one-off thing, or others are like that, but if you read it in the software, in the settings and about phone, there is a chance that you're missing a number. But like I was going to say, I would take this for a Zello Push to Talk radio, quote unquote, over anything that's coming out of China. Now, if I would have had that problem with one of the other overseas manufacturers, I don't know if I would have ever got it to work the way I wanted it to. I know you can just put your SIM card in and it'll work, but then again, that's a chance you're taking on those. But that's another story for another day. Bottom line, if you're looking for something, and it fits within your price range, I would go for this. If you're looking for Zello, it's not going to do TeamSpeak, PTT for you, or all the other, what seems like hundreds of push-to-talk apps out there. It's not going to do that. This is going to do Zello and a few others. If you're on a, if you have a business and you have your own different other than Zello or Zello Work, go to Sonam's website, click partners, and I think you click applications, and then it'll give you a list of all the applications that these will work with. But I would take this over any of the other, you know, Zello devices, radios that are out there. If you have any questions or anything about it, about Zello getting it to work on here, which is just like all the other videos, come back on the playlist. You'll be able to see all that. Any other questions or anything like that, just leave them in the comments. Stay tuned for more.